Here we go. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Justin, and today we're listening to Frank Zappa. You guys have been waiting with his song Peaches and Regalia off of his album Hot Rats, which was released in 1969. Okay, you guys have been asking for Frank Zappa for the longest time, and I've actually purposely not done much from him. And by not much, I mean not anything except one song from him, because I know that he has like a bunch of albums. There's like a tons of songs, and he's just like this mountain to climb, and I'm literally stepping my toe on the foot of the mountain. So I knew it was an overwhelming task, so I went to Twitter, and I asked on Twitter what songs I should listen to. And of course, I got a landslide of songs to listen to, which, by the way, you guys could probably join me on Twitter, because sometimes I ask stuff like that. And Peaches and Regalia seem to be one of the more recommended songs, so you know what, I said, let's do a little Peaches. I've listened and watched interviews from him, and he seems like a really cool guy. Really interesting and very smart and intelligent. I just don't really know much about his music. Let's see. This is Peaches and Regalia by Frank Zappa. Interesting. Okay, so instrumental, first thing, Which obviously I knew because I couldn't find any lyrics and it did say instrumental. But I'm coming into Frank Zappa very ignorant. I don't know like anything about him, really, right? I don't even really know what instruments he plays. I know that he's a multi-instrumentalist, but I don't really know what, like, you know, he is his thing. Here I'm seeing that he's playing bass and some percussion, and the bass playing throughout is very fantastic. I really enjoy it. Actually, all the instruments are fantastic in this one. the keyboard, the horns, bass especially, but drums. Drums are really good. Ron Sellico on the drums, and it's funny because on the keyboards, the flute and the saxophone and clarinet, it said Ian Underwood, and I thought it said Ian McDonald, and I was like, what? Mm-hmm. And the song does have a very cool atmosphere about it. It does sound like a jazz song, but like a fun and playful jazz song. And I mean, jazz as a genre is very improvisational, and there's a lot of back and forth, conversationally between the musicians, blah, 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 blah. Right, but this one feels like like they're on a playground of instruments, and they're just like, yeah, just play with these, you know? And some of the random sounds that kind of come in and out really give me that idea of them just kind of like hanging out. And the song really feels like it's made up of a lot of different pieces, but I do feel like they flow relatively well. The sounds and the solos that take, you know, front and center stage between the sections do sound really nice. They kind of keep the overall groove going, especially drums and bass. I like this part when the music kind of picks up a little bit melodically. Yeah, that sounds really good. I like that. And then we get back into some organ playing. Like I said, they're kind of trading back and forth. You can tell like it sounds pretty complex. This is like a pocket jazz song, right? It's only 3 minutes long, but they pack a lot into 3 minutes, admittedly. Gotta admit, I don't like love it. I think it sounds cool, and I'm slightly curious about more. I don't love it though. I feel like it's just, I don't know. See, here's where all the Zappa fans come, because like, I like it in a sense, but it's not like what I would listen to, like repeatedly. It doesn't like capture me. Horns are killer. I mean, really, instrumentally, the whole song is killer. And even here, I'm not sure what that is. Even there, I like the organ in the back. Production is really nice in the song as well, in capturing the essence of the back and forth between the musicians. And this was just a smooth break. This is smooth. I guess, like, in the end, I'm kind of left wanting, like, more out of the song. And you guys know what I feel. You guys kind of know my taste and everything. I like the parts of the song, I just wish that they were developed within each other a little bit more. You know, the song is 3 minutes and 30 seconds. Maybe it's just me, but I wish that it was either a little longer and just expanded upon certain moments, or just take some moments out and put it into different songs. I don't know. I'm willing to try more Zappa. I'm not giving up on him, okay? There's hundreds of songs and I think like hundreds of albums. I don't know. But I'm not done with them. I'm not done with them. This is one of those songs that I find really cool on a first listen, and I'll probably listen to it again. I would love to see a live performance of it, actually. That'd be really cool. But you guys are more than welcome to join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments down below. I hope that you're having a wonderful day. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.